making your WordPress website accessible is not only good design practice, but it also ensures that everyone has equal access to your web content and applications. This means that any visitor, regardless of disability or impairment, should be able to access and use your site. This is important when you consider the fact that 1 in 4 adults in the United States has a disability of some kind. In other words, if you're not building with accessibility in mind, up to 1/4 of your website's visitors may struggle to access your content. But fortunately, there is a set of guidelines you can use to review your web design and functionality. The W3C standards outline several levels of accessibility. Of course, you'll also want to take laws and regulations into account, since accessibility is a legal matter as well. In this video, we'll take a look at what accessibility means online. We'll also dive into some of WordPress's new additions that make accessible design easier. There's a lot to cover, so let's get started. Number one, make sure your site is keyboard friendly. Put simply, for a website to be accessible, it must work without the use of a mouse. This is because many assistive technologies for people with physical disabilities rely on keyboard-only navigation. As such, it must be possible to use all of your site's major features via a keyboard and nothing else. This includes accessing all pages, links, content, and so on. The most common way of navigating using a keyboard is with a tab key. This will jump between areas on a page that can have keyboard focus, which includes links, buttons, and forms. Therefore, your goal should be to ensure that all web content and navigation can be accessed using tab. This is easy to test. Simply use your own site without a mouse. And if you find that you can't access certain elements or that navigating is difficult, you can pinpoint those issues and address them. To help you out with this, WebAIM provides a handy guide for keyboard accessibility design. See the link in the description box below for more info. Number two. Make sure all content is easily accessible for the vision impaired. While this is usually not a problem, it can be an issue when a page contains dynamic content. In short, content is dynamic if it can change without the page it's on reloading. This can become a problem because the user will miss the new content if the site doesn't inform assistive tools of the change. One way you can do this is by using ARIA landmarks. These are tags you add to content in order to clearly define it on the page. With ARIA, you can tag dynamic content as a live region, which enables screen readers and similar devices to understand the content as it changes. ARIA is also useful for making navigation more straightforward as it lets users skip directly to the specific content. The Make WordPress Accessible Handbook contains a section on ARIA landmarks that's linked in the description box below. It's also worth noting that all WordPress themes with the Accessibility Ready tag will have ARIA landmarks added by default. Number three, add alt text to all images. When adding images to WordPress, you've probably noticed this field. Here, you can enter the alternative text for an image, and this text acts as a replacement for the image if it fails to load. However, alt text, sometimes called alt attributes, alt descriptions, or alt tags, is also accessed by screen readers to read the picture for the blind. You can, therefore, use this field to describe an image, giving context to users who would otherwise miss it. As if that weren't enough, alt text can also help you improve your site's SEO, giving search engines more information to crawl. Just make sure to write descriptive summaries of each image and try to include your keywords whenever it makes sense. Number four, choose your colors carefully. We often talk about colorblind lists as if it's a no pun intended black and white issue. However, it's more of a spectrum since different people perceive colors in unique ways. As such, you need to make sure the colors you select on your site contrast well to ensure that everyone can distinguish between various elements on the page. The most pressing issue is making sure text stands out against the background. Ideally, you should set a dark color against a light one, making sure that they don't bleed into each other. You'd want to avoid creating a palette where the shades are too similar in hue and saturation, like this. You'll also want to avoid clashing colors that could cause eye strain. There are plenty of online tools you can use to find and test color combinations. WebAIM has one, and there's also Contrast Checker, which gives you an effectiveness score in real time. Number five, use headers to structure your content correctly. Another key task to make sure your site's accessible is structuring your content by using headers carefully. Doing this will make your content much easier to understand and digest. Additionally, clear headers also help screen readers interpret your pages. This makes it much easier to provide in-page navigation. It's also simple to do, since you only need to ensure that you use the correct heading levels in your content. For instance, you should only use one H1 per page, usually as the page title. This can be followed by subheading starting with H2, which can then be nested further with H3, followed by H4. Number 6, don't use tables for anything except tabular data. When it comes to displaying data, tables are handy. They make it much easier for all users, including those using assistive technology, to parse a large amount of data. To get the maximum benefit, however, you'll want to keep your tables as simple as you can. In addition, it's best to avoid using tables for anything but tabular data. For example, you should never use a table for layouts, lists, or anything else. This can be confusing to screen readers and similar devices. If you do need to create more complex tables, you can follow this guide from W3 that is listed in the description box below. It shows you how to code a table while maintaining accessibility standards. Number 7, enable resizable text that doesn't break your site. Most devices and browsers will enable users to resize text, which can be helpful for those with visual impairments. However, if you don't build your site to support this feature, resizing text could break your design or make it difficult to interact with your site. To make sure your site meets these criteria, test your font sizes thoroughly by increasing the zoom level in your own browser. If you notice that content becomes difficult to read or navigate, you can check out this guide by WebAIM linked below that discusses font size. Number 8, avoid automatic media and navigation. As annoying as it can be to have music or videos start when a page loads, this is an even bigger issue in terms of accessibility. For example, figuring out how to turn off the media can be difficult when using a screen reader, while other users could simply be confused or even frightened by the sound of sudden noise. You should therefore avoid including elements that start without the user first prompting them. It's also best to avoid automatic navigation, such as carousels and sliders. This can be incredibly frustrating if the viewer needs more time to absorb all of the information before moving on to the next slide. Number 9, create content with accessibility in mind. Finally, we come to the core of your site, its content. While designing your site for accessibility is hugely important, you should bear the same considerations in mind when creating content. This means paying attention to relatively minor things, such as always fully writing out acronyms, to more important points, like making sure you give all your links unique descriptive names and anchor text. Web content accessibility matters. Making sure that your site is welcoming to as many people as possible should be a top priority. There's no reason to exclude anybody, especially since it's relatively easy to avoid doing so. Not only will your users thank you, but you'll also likely see benefits in the form of increased traffic and conversions. Thank you for joining us. For more helpful tips on how to build and grow your website, visit our YouTube channel. We'll be waiting for you.